I could spend the next 20 minutes going through this man's credits after his football career. He's just a great friend. I love this guy, and I've known him for a very long time, and I'm thrilled to have him here on the Rich Eisen Show, certainly on this day, because he can answer. We're all wondering what was Gronk's reasoning and all that stuff. I forgot about what Gronk was also doing. He was on the set on NFL on Fox, so he can actually pinpoint which member of the NFL on Fox Gronk couldn't stand so much that he went back to play football. His name's Michael Strahan. How are you, Stray?
Hey, I just hope it wasn't me, man.
Oh, I don't think it was.
Hello, fellas.
How are you, Michael?
The news yesterday actually made me happy for Gronk.
Yep.
Really, it made me happy for him and for Tom and for, you know, all the Tampa fans out there. It's going to be a good, you know, it's going to make this season interesting. But I really think he wanted to go back to play. As a matter of fact, he made a lot of us lose bets at Fox because some of us didn't think he'd make it through the season without going back last year.
Right.
But I think he wants to have fun. I mean, everybody can attest. Most of the guys who play with the Patriots under Belichick, they'll say he's a fantastic coach. We all know he's one of the best coaches. But it's not necessarily fun to play there and fun to play for him. So I think that Gronk just wants to have a little fun with Tom.
I guess in all seriousness, you would know it. You would spot it. Did you get some sense when Gronk was there that, you know, whether it was watching the games or how he was into it or that he actually did – miss it or maybe even regret retiring to make it in pretty stronger terms?
Like he was, I didn't feel like when he was around us, like you could say he was regretting retiring. I think he said, hey, I'm retired. I'm going to enjoy this year.
Right.
I think the situation with Tom made it a little bit more interesting and unique for him. So I think that's why he did it. But no, you never got that sense. I think he gave us everything he had at Fox. He was an absolute joy and pleasure to be around. What you see on the field and off the field, he's the same guy, which you love him. You love this guy. You root for him. So I know there's no one at Fox who can say a bad word about working with him. And we all are excited to see what he's going to do out there on the field. We're all rooting for him.
No doubt about that. And, Stray, I've never asked you this question, so I might as well ask it on live television and radio and stream. Did you ever come close to coming back after retiring? Did you ever get a call?
Yeah, I did.
What happened?
Yeah, I did. I was in Greece, as a matter of fact. I've never had taken, a real vacation.
Right.
And after 15 years, I said, money, no object. I'm going on a great vacation. I go to Greece. I'm in Santorini. I get a call from my agent saying the Giants want me to come back. O.C. Uerman, Yura got hurt. They're going to, you know, pay me a lot more money. And for about 30 minutes, I was ready. And then I looked outside and I said, man, Greece or New Jersey? But I decided Greece kind of won out. So I'd say retired. But the hardest thing is, and Gronk is young. Yeah, I was 36 at the time. And whenever you really start, when it's not in your heart, don't do it. Don't cheat the game. Don't just go out there because they can make money. You see that too often. You got to play with your heart if you want to be a great player. And I just couldn't stand being out there knowing I'm making a nice check and making a nice living, but I'm not giving it everything that I have as I always did. That would have disappointed me more than a success I would have had before one comeback year that may not have been as successful.
Well, you know Tom, too, Stray. I mean, Brady is quite the draw as well. I mean, I'm wondering, you know, that clearly had a ton to do with it. And these guys, I mean, with Godwin and Evans and Arians with Leftwich dialing it up, this is some serious business right now with the Bucs.
It could be pretty ugly for that. I mean, it's a tough division. You have Matt Ryan. You still have Drew Brees, of course. And, you know, we have Bridgewater down in Carolina. So still a tough division. But this definitely, if Tom Brady called just about anybody, it's like Michael Jordan's calling you to say, hey, come join the Bulls. What are you going to do? You're going to do it. If he called me, I might get my old self in shape to go back out there right now. Yeah. So he just got that kind of draw. But I think for Tom, when Tom had the realization, because I've talked to him about it a little bit, when he realized that, you know what, it was time that he didn't realize how good it felt to move on until he knew he was moving on. I think once that settled in, he was very comfortable with going somewhere else. And one thing we know about him, he's going to do what he wants to do. You only have so long in your life that you can play this game, and a lot of guys don't get a chance to end it the way that they want. He's going to end it the way that he wants, regardless of people's ideas of him retiring or saying he's 41, 40, 42, whatever the heck he is, I forget. He's going to do what he wants to do, and he deserves the right to do that with 6 Super Bowl rings on his finger.
Well, speaking of, you know, ending it the way you want, I mean, you, Michael Strahan, are, you know, along with Bettis, what, Elway, Ray Lewis, just it's so rare to end it the way you want. It's so, I mean, we're just seeing it right now with The Last Dance. I don't know if you caught any of that on Sunday night on ESPN.
You know what I'm saying?
Like, you're seeing that even Jordan, it couldn't end the way that he wanted, right? So that's part of the reason why I think people are maybe even surprised why Brady didn't retire after a Super Bowl win, and that he's so willing to go trade on a different uniform. You would know that about that as well. Would you have ever come out for a different uniform, or the concept that you retired the way that you did or as a Giant was so strong, Michael?
Yeah, I think for me, I would have gone out with the Giants. After being there for so long, if I were 7 years in the league, 8 years, that's one thing with one team. But 15 years with one team, I would have been very happy to say, you know what, that was a good run. I am out of here. But everybody's different. I don't judge anybody about how they operate and what they want to do. I mean, Jordan came back and played for the Wizards after baseball. I mean, God, he went to a whole other sport to get away from it. But I just look and go, somebody has a desire to play and somebody still wants them to play, then God bless them. But for me, the Giants were the only one, and I'm glad I didn't have the opportunity or didn't choose to go somewhere else, because it just worked out great for myself and for my family. And at the end of it, to win a Super Bowl, that's the luckiest thing you can ever do. At least in my case, I felt like it was lucky, because no one expected our team to do much.
Pro Football Hall of Famer, and also from Good Morning America with the great Robin Roberts and the whole rest of the cast on ABC, and also the man who helped me live out the dream of trying to give away cash and prizes on the $100,000 pyramid that he hosts, Michael Strahan, here on the Rich
Eisen
Show.
Hey, I love watching you run these 40s, man, for St. Jude. You're killing it. You're killing it, man.
Well, I know.
I'm surprised you haven't pulled a hamstring or nothing. I mean, it's really something.
Well, I'm a fine wine, Michael, and you know my wife, Susie, makes sure that if I'm not training, and she and Dion are the ones that are all over me about training, so you know that's a very important thing. And you've been...
Well, I love when Prime breaks it down with commentary on your running.
Well, and you're going to be with me and Prime and Kevin Hart at the top of the NFL Draft-A-Thon on Thursday night, when that is also to raise funds and awareness for 6 particular charities that are associated with fighting COVID-19 and or providing relief for those under the thumb of this scourge. And I'm wondering what life is like for you. Obviously, we are all who are broadcasting every day. It's not like we're on the front lines of fighting this. But, I mean, just finding the right mix, in a way, of talking about things in this world of day and age, as you're doing on Good Morning America right now, Stray.
Yeah, I mean, it's a little tough, because you realize that everybody's isolated. Everybody's frustrated. People are tired of being home. But at the same time, it's about what's best for everybody, you know, about safety, mm-hmm. about protecting yourself and your family and everyone else. So, GMA, you know, for me to go into work every day, at least it breaks it up for me. It breaks up my day, gives me something to look forward to and something to do. But they've done a great job there with a skeleton crew of people, and everybody's got on masks and gloves, and they've been very careful how we've operated in that building, so it's a comfortable environment. But at least I have a purpose. But I can see, just being at home, it would drive you absolutely nuts. Mm-hmm. This is a good time to reset, I found. Even for me, having the time to come home, and it gives me time to reset what the priorities are, what's important, how I want my life to be once we are out of this. Maybe there's some things that I do now or some things I've been doing that I don't want to do anymore. I realize they don't make me happy. I want to do things that make me happy and fill my time the way that I want my time to feel, because if there's ever a lesson in all of this, is that time is very precious. It's the one thing in the world that you cannot get more of, and you better savor it and enjoy every bit of it, because you don't know when it all ends. And I just hope people understand that, and they are careful out there. And I know you have some people who are still running the streets and protesting and doing all these things, and everybody has a right to do that. But just because numbers are going down, it doesn't mean that the disease is done, the virus is over. Just mean that people have been staying away from each other and going by what they've been told, which is the quarantine and practice safe practices when it comes to distancing yourself. But if we stop doing those things, we may take a big step backwards. And big story today that in the wintertime, you know, this fall, it may even be worse than what it is now. So we kind of got to guard against those things while we can right now, and hopefully it won't be as bad in the future, and we'll come up with some kind of antidote for this.
Yeah, the head of the CDC saying that if, you know, he could see it being even worse next winter because it would coincide with the regular flu season, and that's why, again, what we can all do maybe now to help avoid all that, and then help those that are most in need right now. We got Gary Vee on in the last hour. You took part in the All-In Challenge that Michael Rubin and Gary Vee and others who have put together. You put together a very nice of course you can put together a nice package here, man.
I don't know how nice it is. It's like kind of like hang out with me all day.
That excited. That's not bad. Four VIP tickets to a Good Morning America concert. Again, this is when we all get back to normal. A trip to your man cave for lunch and a ride in your favorite car. What is your man cave?
His favorite car, but probably that I have a lot of favorite cars, so it's not even a ride my favorite car. It's a ride in whatever you want to ride in.
Okay, I like that.
And multiple rides. It's not just one thing, but yeah.
Okay.
That and what else? You know, myself and you know my partner Constance, we have Smack Productions, so we're doing, you know, we always have something we're working on, so give somebody the opportunity to have a role as an extra in one of our upcoming productions. And I've given you clothes before, so I'm going to take somebody, and if a lady bids and she wants to give it to her kid, her man, whoever she wants, we're going to give them the outfit, a collection of suits, custom-made suits from a tailor, and also some MSX, which is the athleisure from my line. And then I'm going to come to $100,000 pyramid, four more passes. Maybe you'll be on in, and they can come watch you win somebody else a lot of money.
That'd be great. Honestly,
how great would that be?
Michael, I'm telling you, the staff there, because Constance Schwartz and the rest of the staff there at the pyramid, awesome. It was such an amazing day. And then watching you as a game show host is just so much fun. I get pleasure in just seeing that myself. You know, I just seeing the whole, and then just being on that set. And trying to give clues, receive clues, is a lot of pressure.
But you know what I love, though, Rich, is the fact that you were like, hey, man, I really want to come. I love this show, blah, blah, blah. But you really meant it. And we've had everybody who comes on and plays the game, once they finish that first round, they're like, oh, or the first, their one game or whatever, they want to come back. Because it's fun. It's a lot of fun. We try to keep the atmosphere fun and light.
Great.
And it's been working out for us really well. So hopefully when this whole situation is over, we can film the upcoming season. That's in our plans.
A few more minutes left with Michael Strahan here on the Rich Eisen Show. Obviously, this draft will be unlike any other, one we'll never forget and one that we hopefully will never repeat. And that goes for the prospects as well. Mm-hmm. What was your draft night like? Michael, back
in the day. Sitting at my Uncle Ray's house in Houston, Texas, with my family, with a sandwich, like a sub sandwich that fed like 12 people, a few big liters of Coke, Coca-Cola, and that was about it. It's not like these guys now, man, it's like so special. They got all the outfits and all this. I'm wearing a pair of sweats. Just hoping that I can get a job so I don't have to stay living with my parents, you know, or go back to living with my parents. But it's a big night, and it's sad that these kids won't get to experience that. But the excitement of their careers really begins once they get an opportunity to go to their new team to step on the field. And they can easily make up for this draft day in some way, shape, or form. But at least it's going to happen. Goodell's going to be in his basement, which I'm curious to see what that looks like. And, what does Roger Goodell's basement look like?
He says it's where he watches games when he's not out on the road. That's where he's going to be. Also, apparently, it's right adjacent to the laundry room, to the Goodell laundry room. So he may be putting in a load or two while he's in between making picks, you know?
Yeah, I expect to see like a old like 20-inch tube TV, black and white, with some rabbit ears on it, and one of the kids has to hold the antenna so the signal comes through clearly.
Right.
And then he goes, put it on this game, and the kid has to change the channel with his hand flipping the switches.
Well, I just want to make, you know, I'm falling into this trap too, Michael, because you'll see when you come on the NFL Draft-a-thon with me and Dion and Kevin Hart and Brady, by the way.
Looking
it's going
to
be amazing.
To
on Thursday night, you'll see. I fall into the trappings of on-air sports person from home office with books that I haven't read in years right behind me on the shelf to make me look well read. You know that I've got that going on, and I'm wondering if Roger might have that too. I don't know.
Well, you know what? I have a lot of books in the background that have not been read. Maybe I should just do it in front of the bar with a lot of tequila that I probably have.
Yeah, hey, it's 5 o'clock somewhere when we're on when we're on that night, no doubt about it. So, did Dan Reeves call you at home? Is that what happened in '93?
George Young called me at home.
Oh God! Oh man!
And I talked to Dan Reeves as well. And when I got drafted, I was like, "Why New York?" I had all the scouts. They would come to Texas Southern University. They would work me out. And then Jeremiah Davis, who was a scout for he would come in and just scout TSU specifically. And he would put me through all these drills. And he was the only scout that put me through all these drills of all these scouts who would not feed me afterwards, wouldn't buy me a burger. But he would work me to death.
Yeah.
And I was like, man, these cheap old Giants, I don't want to go there. They're not going to draft me. And Earl Leggett, who's rest in peace, I love him. Without Earl, I would not have had a football career that I had. And Earl, he came one time, sat in the back, never said anything to me, really. So I never thought the Giants were really interested. And then when they drafted me, I thought, they got LT. They don't need me. What am I going to do up there? Plus, it's cold. And but it was the perfect fit, perfect coach, perfect organization. And with the patience, a perfect win to end my career.
What did LT, how did he welcome you as a rookie?
He didn't. So you know what? I love Lars, man. LT was really fantastic. He was one of these, he didn't have to say anything. Like when he walked in, he glided in. He didn't have to move his leg. It was weird. He was just such an icon. But he worked hard. That's one thing I think people never realize. This guy, in practice, when he did show up for practice, he went all out. Key word, when he did show up for practice, he went all out. But he was fun to learn from because he didn't pick on you. He wasn't, you know, a lot of guys took pride in picking on you and messing with you. He was a grown man with a life. So he only talked to you and messed with you if he had to. Other than that, he wanted to include you in things. They would have parties, and he said, you got to come. This is mandatory.
Uh-oh.
Tell your wife you got to be there. And, a lot of fun for a rookie. A lot of eye-opening moments.
That's funny. How did he welcome you, and you said he didn't? That says it all, quite honestly,
yeah.
Michael. That says it all.
But he would give you the shirt off his back. I will tell you that. Rookie or not, he would. Once you made that team, he would do anything for you. And to this day, I have all the respect in the world, man. He is the defensive GOAT, in my opinion, of the NFL.
Straight, really appreciate the time, man. I will speak with you in the draft-a-thon room Thursday night. In the meantime, check Michael Strahan out. Good Morning America, Fox Football Now, part of a rotating cast. Check out MSX by MichaelStrahan.com. And, of course, try and bid and get that all-in challenge to hang with Stray when we're all through on the other side of this. Love you, man. You take care.
I love you too, brother. I'll see you on the Thursday.
You got it. That's Michael Strahan right here on the Rich Eisen Show, at Michael Strahan, Twitter, Instagram, the whole schmear. Hey, you watched all the way to the end. Thanks for that. Watch more right here.